Hello everyone, welcome to Grab and Go Info. Multiple treatments sometimes are compared with a control group, and with each other in an experiment. The experiment outcome can be continuous results such as sales, or binary results such as a response to a promotion. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to use the Python package CausalML to build MetaLearner Uplift models for an experiment with multiple treatments and binary outcomes. We will cover how to implement S-learner, T-learner, and X-learner on multiple treatments, how to make an average treatment effect estimation for multiple treatments, how to make individual treatment effects for multiple treatments, how to get the confidence intervals for the average treatment effect and individual treatment effect estimation. To learn how to build multiple treatments uplift models for continuous outcomes, please check out my previous tutorial Multiple Treatments Uplift Model Using Python Package CausalML. The link for all the tutorials mentioned in the video is in the video description. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. The link for the code is in the video description. Firstly, let's install CausalML in the matplotlib version 3.4.2. Matplotlib version 3.4.2 is installed because a matplotlib version later than 3.4.0 has a new functionality of adding labels to visualization. After the installation and restarting the runtime, we can import the libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. Seaborn is imported for visualization. Base S classifier, Base T classifier, and Base X classifier are MetaLearner Uplift models. XGB classifier, XGB regressor, LGBM classifier, and LGBM regressor are machine learning algorithms. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the multiple treatments uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the CausalML Python package, we created a synthetic dataset. Mode is for the type of simulation for synthetic dataset creation. It is based on the paper by Nyx and WagerS titled Quasi-Oracle Estimation of Heterogeneous Treatment Effects. One is for difficult nuisance components and an easy treatment effect. Two is for a randomized trial. Three is for an easy propensity and a difficult baseline. Four is for unrelated treatment and control groups. Five is for a hidden confounder biasing treatment. N takes in the number of observations. 5,000 observations are created in this example. P takes in the number of covariates. We created 5 covariates for this dataset. Sigma equals 1 means the standard deviation of the error term is 1. Edge is the adjustment term for the distribution of propensity. High values shift the distribution to 0. The synthetic data method produces 6 outputs. Y is the outcome. X is a matrix with all the covariates. W is the treatment flag with 2 values. 0 represents the control group and 1 represents the treatment group. In this tutorial, W is renamed to treatment. Tau is the individual treatment effect. In this tutorial, tau is renamed to it. B is the expected outcome. E is the propensity score for receiving treatment. From the distribution plot of the outcome Y, we can see that the outcome is a continuous variable ranging from around -2 to around 6. A new binary outcome variable Y binary is created based on the value of the continuous variable. Using a list comprehension, we created a binary variable Y binary and set Y binary to 1 if Y is greater than or equal to 2. Otherwise, we set Y binary to 0. The list comprehension result is in a list format. We change it to a NumPy array using np.array to make the format compatible with the model requirement. We can see that Y binary has 3327 zeros and 1673 ones in the binary outcome. The Python CausalML package creates one control group and one treatment group by default. We use the random function from NumPy to split the treatment group into two treatment groups, treatment 1 and treatment 2. We can see that out of 5,000 samples, 2421 units did not receive treatments, 1235 received treatment 1, and 1344 received treatment 2. In step 3, we will estimate the average treatment effect and the individual treatment effect for multiple treatments using an S-learner. To learn more about the average treatment effect and the individual treatment effect, please check out my previous tutorial 8 vs. Kate vs. ATT vs. ATC for causal inference. S-learner is a meta-learner that uses a single machine learning model to estimate the individual level causal treatment effect. To estimate the average treatment effect for multiple treatments, we first initiate the base S classifier because we would like to estimate the impact on the binary outcome Y binary. Base S classifier is a generalized method that can take in existing machine learning models from packages such as Sclearn and XGBoost and run S learners with those models. Here we are using the XGB classifier as the modeling algorithm, but it can be replaced by any other binary classification model algorithm. Random state ensures the model results reproducible, and control name tells the meta-learner the name of the control group. After initiating the model, we can get the average treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound using the estimate 8 method. Besides passing in the covariates, the treatment variable, and the outcome variable, we need to specify return psi equals true to get the confidence interval for the estimated average treatment effect. We can see from the outputs that the estimated average treatment effect for treatment 1 is 0.19. The lower bound is 0.16 and the upper bound is 0.22. The estimated average treatment effect for treatment 2 is 0.18. The lower bound is 0.15 and the upper bound is 0.21. Next, let's estimate the individual treatment effect for multiple treatments. Individual treatment effect is the difference between the predicted outcomes with and without treatment. The method fit predict produces the estimated individual treatment effect. From the first five results, we can see that the individual treatment effect is estimated for both treatments. The first column corresponds to the individual treatment effect for treatment 1 and the second column corresponds to the individual treatment effect for treatment 2. We can print out the individual treatment effect estimation for each record. For example, the second record has the individual treatment effect of 0.07 for treatment 1 and 0.06 for treatment 2. If the confidence interval for the individual treatment effect is needed, we can use Bootstrap by specifying the bootstrap number, bootstrap size, and setting return psi equals true. The output gives us both the estimated individual treatment effect and the estimated upper and lower bound for each treatment. The first columns for the individual treatment effect and its upper bound and lower bound correspond to treatment 1, and the second columns correspond to treatment 2. We can print out the individual treatment effect estimation and its upper bound and lower bound for each record. The second record has the individual treatment effect of 0.07 for treatment 1. The lower bound is -0.02, and the upper bound is 0.25. The second record has the individual treatment effect of 0.06 for treatment 2. The lower bound is -0.04, and the upper bound is 0.21. To learn more about S-Learner, please check out my previous tutorials S-Learner Uplift Model for Individual Treatment Effect and Customer Segmentation in Python, and Explainable S-Learner Uplift Model using Python package CausalML. In step 4, we will estimate the average treatment effect and the individual treatment effect for multiple treatments using a T-Learner. T-Learner follows three steps to estimate the individual treatment effect and the average treatment effect. Firstly, two machine learning models are built, one using the treated units and the other using the untreated units. Next, the predictions will be made using the two models separately for all the units, both treated and control. Finally, the individual treatment effect will be estimated by getting the difference between the predicted outcome from the treated model and the predicted outcome from the control model. The average treatment effect is the average of the individual treatment effect. The Python CausalML package implements those steps for T-Learner, and we can initiate the model using base T classifier. The binary classification algorithm used is LGBM classifier, but we can use any other binary classification algorithm. Similar to the S-Learner, the T-Learner gets the average treatment effect estimation using Estimate 8, and the individual treatment effect using Fit Predict. We can use Bootstrap to get the individual treatment effect with a confidence interval. To learn more about T-Learner, please check out about my previous tutorials T-Learner Uplift Model for Individual Treatment Effect in Python, an explainable T-Learner deep learning uplift model using Python package CausalML. In step 5, we will estimate the average treatment effect and the individual treatment effect for multiple treatments using an X-Learner. X-Learner consists of three stages, and each stage has a model that estimates different dependent variables. Stage 1 is the same as the T-Learner. It builds two machine learning models to predict the outcomes, one using the treated units and the other using the control units. After the stage 1 models are built, the imputed individual treatment effect will be calculated. For the samples that receive treatment, the imputed individual treatment effect is the actual outcome minus the counterfactual outcome predicted by the control model from stage 1. For the samples that did not receive treatment, the imputed individual treatment effect is the counterfactual outcome predicted by the treated model from stage 1 minus the actual outcome. Stage 2 builds two machine learning models to predict the imputed individual treatment effect. One model is trained using the treated units, and the other model is trained using the untreated units. After the Stage 2 models are completed, the imputed individual treatment effect predictions will be calculated separately using the treated and the control model for all the samples. Stage 3 builds a propensity model to predict the propensity of getting treatment. The predicted propensity score is used as the weight for the individual treatment effect calculation. Finally, the individual treatment effect will be estimated by getting the weighted average of the Stage 2 model predictions, using the propensity scores as the weights. The average treatment effect is the average of the individual treatment effect. The Python CausalML package implements those steps for X-Learner and we can initiate the model using base X classifier. In this example, we set treatment outcome learner equals XGB classifier, treatment effect learner equals XGB regressor, control outcome learner equals LGBM classifier, and control effect learner equals LGBM regressor, but we can use other machine learning algorithms. One thing we need to pay attention to is that the outcome learners are all classifiers and the effect learners are all regressors. This is because the outcome learners have binary outcomes and the effect learners have continuous individual treatment effects. Similar to the S learner and the T learner, X learner gets the average treatment effect estimation using estimate 8, and the individual treatment effect using fit predict. We can use Bootstrap to get the individual treatment effect with a confidence interval for X learners too. To learn more about XLearner, please check out my previous tutorial XLearner Uplift Model in Python. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about Uplift Modeling, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.